So you guys, just a few hours ago, Lonzo Ball's day two training camp footage has been released. So this video, I just want to talk about his second practice with the Detroit Pistons and just give you guys an update on Lonzo Ball's situation. Before I start this video, make sure you guys go follow me on Instagram at _TheOnlyWallace, and also go subscribe to my second channel called TK Wallace Vlogs. Now let's get to the video. So first, you guys, I had to bring y'all another update on Lonzo Ball just because they just released some more footage of his day two training camp. And I know I just recently made a video on Lonzo talking about his day one training camp. If you guys have not seen that video, make sure you guys go check it out. I will put the link in the description box below. But today, I ain't gonna lie, I was not planning on making this video, but they released some more footage, so I gotta keep updating you guys. So let's break down this training camp footage. Now off the bat, the first thing I realized is that today they're running with three different groups. Now the players with the blue jerseys, that's the A team, of course, because you could tell, you know, Blake Griffin, he's wearing a jersey. We all know Blake Griffin is a starter for the Detroit Pistons, so he's on the A team, including Killian Hayes, who they just drafted. I've been hearing good things about Killian, including Derrick Rose. He's been saying that Killian is the future. And I also read an article that he was the starting guard, you know, throughout practice. So Killian is definitely doing his thing. I cannot wait to see him just ball out throughout the season. Now, the players that's wearing the gray jerseys, that's the B team, of course. You know, they have D Rose, Jahlil Okafor. And the players that's wearing the red jerseys, that's the C team, which is Lonzo Ball and all the other players that's trying to make the team. So as you can see, Lonzo, he's doing his thing. I really wish we could see way more footage, or actually behind the scene footage, just to see how Lonzo is actually acting, you know, during these training camps, just to see what type of energy he has. I want to know if he's nervous or not. In my opinion, I don't really think Lonzo is nervous, but at the same time, you know, this is his first time ever having training camps and stuff like that. So, I mean, his day one training camp, he probably was nervous a little bit, but today's training camp, I don't think he probably was that nervous, but we just got to see. Now, just watching the video and stuff, you can tell that they was doing drills and stuff, of course, and they also was scrimmaging. So the team that Lonzo Ball was running with, he was scrimmaging with that team. Hopefully they can release some scrimmage footage. That's what I really want to see, because I want to see how Lonzo Ball is running with these guys, you know, coming off the screens. I just want to see his type of pace he's running on the NBA level, because we all know this is his first time ever having training camps and just doing scrimmages on the NBA level. So I just really want to see how he's handling himself. But you know, I really feel like Lonzo Ball, he got the confidence. Like I was saying in my previous video when I was talking about his first training camp, I was just saying that Lonzo Ball's ticket to the NBA is this jump shot, of course, and also just having the confidence. And him just having that type of confidence, such as him balling out in a training camp and just showing no fear, you know, shooting any type of shot, as in showing the Detroit Pistons, look, I'm a scorer. If I get the ball, I'm gonna make sure I get a bucket for you guys. And that's the main thing that he just need to focus on. I ain't gonna say take bad shots, but you know, don't be scared to take shots. You know what I mean? Some people, when they have a new opportunity, you know, or they get on a new team or something like that, they be so scared, they like to hold back because they don't want to shoot bad shots and stuff like that. I just really hope Lonzo Ball, he's not overthinking and he's not holding back, because that's the main thing about this training camp. Do not hold back, ball out, because he has to outshine all the guys that he's competing with. And I'm gonna be honest with you guys, Lonzo Ball has to outshine five guys, but I'm gonna break it down to you guys. So basically, we all know the Detroit Pistons, they signed Louis King and Sabin Lee to two-way contracts. So basically, Louis King and Sabin Lee, they both might have the opportunity to convert their contract to a regular season contract, or they could get released. So we got to see what happens between those two. And the other three guys, Anthony Lamb, who was on an exhibition 10 deal with the Detroit Pistons as well with Lonzo Ball, he signed a two-way deal with the Detroit Pistons. And Lonzo, he's going to be competing against Dejan Musa and also Develtas Sarvidis. Both those guys are overseas players. So it's just like Lonzo Ball, he really going to have to compete with these guys and outshine all of them so he can make the roster. Because the only way he can get that two-way contract, he got to outshine Louis King and Sabin Lee, and including Anthony Lamb. So he really do got a lot of things he have to do, you guys. I know a lot of people is so excited that Lonzo Ball, you know, he's with the Pistons, he's actually training with these guys and everything, but don't get ahead of yourselves. Like, he still got a lot of work he has to do. we all know the preseason is right around the corner. They play against the New York Knicks very, very soon. And I read an article that Lonzo Ball, he will be dressing out and he will be playing during the preseason. So if Lonzo do end up playing, he has to shine. If I was him, I would not be worrying about nobody. I know he is competing against other guys, but this is the NBA. You know what I mean? Like, this is the highest level. So, of course, you're going to be competing with other guys. But he has to focus on himself, and he only has to worry about himself. He got to stay locked in and just have the most confidence he can have. Because if he do end up playing against the New York Knicks, yo, Lonzo, he better be shooting the lights out, man. He better be calling for that ball. He better be ready every single second, man. And when he do get that ball, he better make that shot. Because it's just like, we don't know if he's going to get the ball a lot anyways if he do end up playing. So it's just like, Lonzo really has to be ready, because anything can happen, man, like for real. And I just know this is a really big opportunity for him, and he just cannot pass up on this. He cannot hold back. He has to make sure he's playing 130%. And let's say if he don't play good throughout the preseason in the Detroit Pistons, they're not really rocking with him to give him that two-way deal. So if he do end up getting cut by Detroit, he can still sign to the Grand Rapid Drive, who is the Detroit Pistons G League team, and he can get paid up to $50,000 if he stayed with them for 60 days. So it's just like, Lonzo, he can still play in the G League and he's still going to get paid. So regardless, he's still going to be a G League player. He is still in the league. So it's not like Lonzo can get cut and he's not in the NBA and stuff like that no more. Like, no, he can still play just like how when he was on the OKC Blue. It's just we couldn't really see him play with that team because of everything that happened with the virus. And on top of that, his situation being a practice player, he just had to work himself in that roster. But if he do sign with the Grand Rapid Drive, he's already going to be on that roster. So most likely he might end up starting, or he might come off the bench, but he's going to get some minutes. So regardless, Lonzo, he's going to be playing this season. But it's just like, at the end of the day, we try to get him in the NBA. Even if he do make the Detroit Pistons and they have him on the bench, I'd rather him be on the actual Detroit Pistons team instead of, you know, being in the G League and stuff like that. So we just got to see what's going to happen. I'm very excited because this upcoming season is coming very fast. And just imagine how LeVar feel. He got Lonzo in Detroit right now working out in training camp. Got LaMelo in Charlotte working out in training camp with the Hornets. And you got Lonzo, he in New Orleans working in training camp with the Pelicans. So it's just like, you already know LeVar, he's really happy because all three of his boys is getting ready for the season. And they just in different locations. You already know he's probably very, very excited. And I'm just excited too. I know I'm really focused on Lonzo, and the only reason why I'm focused on Lonzo right now is because we're trying to figure out his situation. We're trying to see if he can make the actual league or not, even though he still made the end goal, as in becoming an NBA player, but he got to certify himself in the league now. So that's the only reason why I'm so focused on Lonzo, because he still got a lot of work he has to do. But you already know I'm going to be updating you guys on all three of the Ball Brothers, so stay tuned for that. Like I said, I had a completely different video planned for you guys today, but I'm just end up dropping it tomorrow just because I got to update you guys on Lonzo. So yeah, I definitely want y'all to leave y'all comments and opinions below on how y'all feel about this. And also, just to let you guys know, last year the Pistons, they had a 20-46 record. That's how they finished off their season. So you already know they in rebuilding mode. They trying to find the best players, the best pieces to just add to their team so they can become a playoff team. So Lonzo being a spot up shooter and having a really quick release, and also being 6'5", you know he has an advantage. But we just gotta see what's going to happen. I thank you guys for watching. Please make sure you like, subscribe. Make sure you press the notification button. Take a game. We out.